Hey girl, are you a magician? Because I really want to disappear right now. Hey girl, are you a flower? Because I'm allergic. Hey girl, are you an angel? Because I'd pick you first. No, that wasn't right. Here, let me start over. Hey girl, are you... Hey, you crazy kids, and welcome to Voices in My Closet, where this week I'd like to talk about all things about being in love and just love in general, all things love. Because if you didn't know, I don't know why you wouldn't know, but Valentine's Day is coming up, and it's just around the corner, and I'm sure it's bringing up all these romantic feelings with a lot of people, and for other people, it's just a trigger holiday to make you feel bad and remind you why you're not in a relationship. I'm not going to get too dark with any of that and too sad or I don't want to trigger any of you, but I do want to get into the nitty gritty of why a lot of people like and dislike Valentine's Day. Again, Valentine's Day is the holiday where we take the time to honor those people that we love, whether it is a significant other or a family member or a friend or a group of friends or anybody else that we have, you know, we have a loving relationship with. Unfortunately, a lot of people only see it as a time specifically for their partners and significant others and don't really think about any other thing. And what I'd like to do is play the devil's advocate for Valentine's Day, the anti-Valentine's Day opinion on all of this. Not to say that I have any harsh feelings or anything towards Valentine's Day. I don't want to put my opinion out there and then give all of you reasons to be upset either with me or with the holiday. So I just want to talk about, you know, what's good and what's bad. And to start out, I'm going to start with the dislikes, what people dislike about Valentine's Day. And this could apply to you, this could not apply to you at all, so let me know in the comments if I've missed any reasons why you dislike Valentine's Day or why you like Valentine's Day. And starting out with the idea with single people specifically who dislike Valentine's Day, it could be something of an obligation for a lot of them. They feel the need to be in a relationship, and when they're not in a relationship and Valentine's Day rolls around, it's just one of those triggering things. You know, they feel like they should be, and they're upset that they're not, and they feel like they're not good enough to be in a relationship, or they remember a relationship that could have gone better, and they would still be in it this Valentine's Day if they hadn't messed it up. And you know, they just feel that they just want to be in a relationship, and they really feel bad. Sometimes they'll watch those silly Hallmark Valentine's Day movies, and they get really upset. They curl up eating ice cream, and I'm totally not speaking from experience at all about any of this. And, you know, sometimes even if you don't have a significant other, maybe you feel like you need to have somebody to go on a date with, you know, maybe a first date on Valentine's Day. But, you know, it doesn't have to be that way necessarily. Single people should not have to feel that obligation. And maybe you're a single person who just sees it as an average day and you don't feel any of that kind of pressure. And, you know, you're okay with that. And on the flip side, if you are in a relationship, if you are part of a couple, you probably feel pressure as well to sort of step up your game and show that you love a person even more so than how you express your love on a regular basis. So you kind of need to do more. You need to, you know, buy them gifts and take them out somewhere and just constantly remind them that you love them, even though they do know that. But it is a nice gesture, but there is a question for some people as to whether or not that is necessary. And along the lines of the whole gift-giving thing, I am really curious as to what the ideal gift for Valentine's Day is, because for me, I would not have a problem giving somebody flowers, because I think there are already holidays dedicated to getting somebody in some kind of more higher end extravagant gift, because that's supposed to show that you care a lot about the person and that you know their interests, and you want to show how well you know that person. And we have holidays like Christmas. If you celebrate Christmas and you have that person's birthday, you also have Sweetest Day, which is not as known, not as recognized as Valentine's Day. However, it's still one of those days for your significant other. I always saw Valentine's Day as an added bonus type of thing. You know, you don't have to go all out with a gift that is expensive and all of that for Valentine's Day. Just as an extra nice little gesture to show that you care about this person and that you love them and that you just want to show that you're thinking about them and that you do care about them. I don't think that flowers does not show that. I think that flowers could be a good, nice little kind gift to get somebody. But of course, I am not the love guru here. I don't know everything there is to know about relationships. So what do you think? Ladies, would you be okay getting flowers? Guys, have you gotten flowers for your ladies and they were happy with it? Because I've been told, I was told that, you know, don't get a girl flowers because it's not going to look good. It's going to look too cliche. And I thought, well, I've been doing that. So as far as I knew, nothing was wrong. So I'm curious to know what all of you feel about that. And another thing about being in a relationship is the fact that you have to spend money. You are that person. If you are giving the gift, or if you are taking somebody else out to dinner, you want to be, you know, classy. But that also involves using money and spending money, which is again something that you already do for birthdays and for Christmas and possibly Sweetest Day and other holidays maybe that I haven't listed. Money just becomes an issue, and you know, a lot of people don't want to think about that, spending extra money when you already go on dates with your significant other, your partner, on you know, every week, every couple of weeks, depending on whether or not your partner is busy. And that's actually another possible downside to being in a relationship during Valentine's Day, because you might have a partner who is too busy. Maybe you're in a long distance relationship and you don't have any time to see each other. Valentine's Day falls in the middle of the work week and you're both too busy to see each other, go on a date. And maybe you want to save it for the weekend, which is great. But if you have a busy partner, or if you are the busy partner, then you kind of feel bad. You feel bad that you're not able to celebrate and honor your partner in the way that you would want to. Now, I think it's important to also address the positives of Valentine's Day and why people enjoy the holiday and what's good about it. Valentine's Day is just a day used as an excuse to say I love you. And I think that's great. I think being able to say that you love somebody, whether it is a family member or a friend or a significant other, I think that's always good to be able to honor more than just your boyfriend/girlfriend, because you never want to just make it about one specific person, because while it has been commercialized quite a bit in the past 100 years, Valentine's Day is really meant to honor all of the people that we see as people that we love. And I mean, I love my family members And so I always tell them that I love them, but I'll let them know on Valentine's Day. And I love my friends too. And even with my friends, like, I've gotten Valentines from friends and I've given Valentines to friends. And it's not like it's weird or anything. I don't know why people don't do that more often. It's not a weird thing. Unless you dated one of your friends and then you broke up, but you're still kind of friends. And, then you, again, not speaking from experience, Valentine's Day can be a day where you don't have to feel bad about not being in a relationship because you do have other relationships with friends and with family. Just know that you are loved. It doesn't have to be a romantic kind of love if it doesn't happen to work out for you at the time. There's always that obligation, that expectation to be in a romantic relationship, but I don't think that anyone should stress out about that. Because, you know, you are loved. Somebody's always going to be there for you, whether you think so or not. So just remember that and don't let Valentine's Day be a trigger for you. And another great thing about Valentine's Day is the fact that you get free chocolate. You get free candy. I mean, those candy hearts aren't that great, but free chocolate is... I'm cool with that. If you are the person receiving it, if you're the person buying it, maybe not. But if you are the person receiving it, that's always a good thing. You know, they take advantage of that. Take advantage of getting free candy, either from your partner or from a friend or from the free samples at the market. You know, I'm always up for that. I'm always up for chocolate. I will probably buy myself chocolate for Valentine's Day. I'm definitely considering it. It now that I keep talking about it more and it's sounding more and more tempting. And the question that I want to ask all of you is, I'm not going to get too far into this, but what is your ideal date? You know, since we're talking about relationships and Valentine's Day, it doesn't have to be Valentine's related, but what would your ideal first date be? Any time that you happen to be going on a first date, what do you look for? What kind of activities would you want to do? I know that some people think that dinner and a movie is too movie cliche, and, you know, bungee jumping might be better. But for me, I think bungee jumping is a little terrifying and spontaneous. And I think you want to play it kind of cool, kind of low, kind of slow for your first date with somebody, especially if you want to set a good impression. And sort of you want to keep them engaged, want keep them attracted to you. And there are plenty of different things that you could do, but I'm really curious because, again, I am not an expert in relationships, so I'd very much like to know what all of you believe is the what your ideal first date is, and maybe I can take that into account sometime, because I've had first dates where it's been like a sports game or a movie, or dinner, and sometimes it's gone well, sometimes it's been kind of weird or awkward, and I don't think anyone, as far as I know, I don't know anybody who's ever been able to perfect the first date. So if you have, please teach me your ways. I want to thank you all for listening to this week's episode. Next week, I actually know what I'm going to talk about for next week because it is going to be the 1-year anniversary of when I auditioned for America's Got Talent. So I am going to do an AGT an AGT discussion in all... I can't think of the word... A tell-all, an AGT tell-all. I had the words right, just I mixed them up. So I'm going to tell you all about the misconceived notions that people have about the show, the stuff that happens behind the scenes that I haven't told you about yet, any things that people have brought up with me that show that a lot of people don't really know what goes on with the show and how it works. So look forward to that. Enjoy your week, enjoy your Valentine's Day, whether or not you are single, and I will see you all next week.